Hello friends, welcome to Smart Study. Today we read 2nd November 2017 current affairs. Let's start. Jasprit secured top spot in ICC T20. Indian fast bowler Jasprit Bumrah climbed to the number one spot in the latest ICC T20 ranking, while his fifth ranked team could go as high as second if it beat New Zealand in the three match series beginning. Bumrah, who attained a career-best third position in the ODI ranking, has regained the T20 top spot. Indian captain Virat Kohli also get top ranking in ODI. Hina Sidhu won gold at Commonwealth. Ace Indian shooter Hina Sidhu has bagged gold in women 10-meter air pistol event at Commonwealth Shooting Championship in Brisbane, Australia. Hina shoot a score of 240.8 in the finals to beat Australians Elena Galiabovich, who has to settle for silver after posting 238.2. India also got its second medal through Deepak Kumar as he won bronze in men's 10-meter air rifle event. Chukkapalli appointed as CZ of Korea. Suresh Chukkapalli, chairman of Phoenix Group of Hyderabad, has been appointed as Honorary Consul General in Hyderabad by the Republic of Korea. Suresh Chukkapalli was given charge and vested formally at a ceremony in New Delhi. South Korea is the fourth largest economy in Asia and the 11th largest in the world, known for its global cooperation. Five states celebrate Foundation Day. Five states, Haryana, Madhya Pradesh, Kerala, Chhattisgarh and Karnataka, are celebrating their Foundation Day today, Wednesday, November 1. Prime Minister Narendra Modi tweeted greetings to the state and wished each of them growth and empowerment. Foundation Day is a designated date on which celebration marks the founding of a nation, state or a creation of a military unit. World Vegan Day 2017. In 1994, right after Halloween, chair of the Vegan Society Louise Wallace decided to set November 1st as World Vegan Day. Veganism is practiced both as a diet to abstain from all food items using animal products, as well as a philosophy which rejects the commodity status of animal. One who practices either of the two is said to be a vegan. Rashtriya Ekta Divas, October 31, 2017. October 31st is celebrated as Rashtriya Ekta Divas, National Unity Day in India. This day marks the birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who played an instrumental role in integration of princely state with Indian Union post-independence. The day began with a floral tribute to the Sardar Patel's statue by Prime Minister Narendra Modi at Sardar Patel Chowk in the national capital. Khadri Achyutan dies at 71. Veteran Kannada writer and journalist Khadri Achyutan died after a brief period of illness in Bengaluru. He was 71 years old. He has also contributed to the coinage of new Kannada words. He is a veteran journalist, author, academic and translator of various literacy works. He has written a book in Kannada on ISRO. He has worked on Kannada translation of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel and Dr. Ambedkar. Diya wins medal in ITTF WCC. Indian table tennis player Divya Chitali won a silver medal in the girls' double category of the 2017 ITTF World Cadet Challenge in Suva, Fiji. Diya hails from Mumbai. She was the only Indian player selected to represent Asia in this tournament. Diya also won a gold medal in the team event as part of Team Asia. WB to lease land for football center. West Bengal decided to provide a 15-acre land to All India Football Federation on lease for Rs. 1 to help set up the National Centre of Excellence. CAIFF President Praful Patel said that the Center for Football will be set up with the land in Kolkata with help from the FIFA. The national senior men's and women's football team and the age group team will be housed in this center. ERO Net launched in Rajasthan. Rajasthan Chief Electoral Officer Ashwini Bhagat launched the Election Commission's based project ERO Net. By using this, voters can register their names on electoral roll. It could not identify multiple entries of a voter. Voters can see their registration detail on the official website of the State Chief Electoral Officer CEO Rajasthan.nic.in or through an SMS. Birender re-elected as president of IWLF. Birender Prasad Baishya was re-elected as president of the Indian Weightlifting Federation IWLF in the annual general body meeting. The newly formed executive committee of IWLF consists of 7 vice president, and Sahadev Yadav has become the secretary general. IWLF is a national governing body that oversees weightlifting in India. Narendran as global CEO of Tata Steel. Tata Steel Limited promoted T.V. Narendran as Chief Executive Officer and Managing Director globally. Narendran is 52 years old. He joined the Tata Steel in 1988. He was serving as Managing Director India and Southeast Asia for the past 4 years. Tata Steel Board also reappointed Kaushik Chatterjee as Executive Director and Chief Financial Officer for 5 years. New DG of Bureau of Police Research. Senior Police Officer AP Maheshwari was appointed as Director General of Bureau of Police Research and Development. He is a 1984 batch IPS officer of Uttar Pradesh cadre. He is currently a Special Director in Border Security Force. He has been appointed in place of Miran C. Borwankar. Miran C. Borwankar is a 1981 batch IPS officer of Maharashtra cadre whose tenure ended last month. S.K. Sinha appointed Secretary Security. Senior Police Officer S.K. Sinha was appointed as the Secretary Security in the Cabinet Secretariat. He is a 1983 batch IPS officer of Bihar cadre. He is at present Special Director in the Intelligence Bureau. He has been appointed in place of A.R.K. Kini. Secretary Security is the administrative head of the SPG, who is responsible for monitoring the security arrangement for Prime Minister. Jackson named top earning dead celebrity. Michael Jackson, who died in the year 2009, 8 years ago, is still generating billions of dollars. Jackson named top earning dead celebrity for the 5th time. He was an American singer, songwriter and dancer. He was one of the most popular entertainers in the world and was the best-selling music artist at the time of his death. His earnings have been estimated to be $75 million. SBIWB sanctions fund for solar projects. SBI and the World Bank announced ₹2,317 crore credit facilities to 7 companies to finance grid-connected rooftop solar project. 7 corporate to which the credit facilities have been extended include Adani Group, Hinduja's Renewables, JSW Energy, Tata Renewable, Azure Power, Clean Tech Solar and Hero Solar Energy. These grid-connected rooftop solar project, which will together generate 575 million megawatt. Government sets panel on PSU bank mergers. Union government set up an alternative mechanism panel headed by Finance Minister Arun Jaitley to consider and oversee mergers among India's public sector bank. Union Railway and Coal Minister Piyush Goyal and Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman are also the member of the panel. it is set up to manage mergers more effectively, bank will be able to manage risk in a better way. India, Tunisia agree to combat terror. India and Tunisia agreed to jointly combat terrorism and extremism and scale up bilateral cooperation in the field of security. Sushma Swaraj co-chaired the 12th India-Tunisia Joint Commission meeting with Tunisia Foreign Affairs Minister Khemis Jinoui. Besides conducting a review of bilateral ties, both the ministers discussed regional and international issues of mutual interest. India top list of new TB cases in 2016. According to Global TB Report 2017, released by World Health Organization WHO, India has topped the list of 7 countries, counting for 64% of the 10.4 million new tuberculosis cases worldwide in 2016. Tuberculosis is a contagious disease which affects the lung and is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Every year, 24th March is observed as World Tuberculosis Day across the world. Ramdas launch Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment Ramdas Athavale launches the Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana in Mumbai. Mr. Athavale launched the scheme in Mumbai during 4th workshop of Pradhan Mantri Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. PM Bharatiya Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana is launched with an objective of making quality medicines available at affordable price to all. So friends, this is our 2nd November 2017 current affairs. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button, share the video, comment the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.